Okay, all praises be unto the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Okay, so we're going to start out at 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, and we're going to call this topic the Israel of God. To show and prove by the scriptures, who is the Israel of God?
All right. So what we getting, bro? 1 Corinthians?
Yeah, we want to start at 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, right?
All right, okay, 1 Corinthians 6.
I'm sorry, Galatians 6.
Okay.
Pardon me, Galatians, the 6th chapter.
Galatians, the 6th chapter.
Yeah, and we're going to start at the 12th verse. You want to read for me?
Yeah, sure, bro. Yep.
Okay, we're going to start at the 12th verse.
All right, Galatians 6 and 12. As many as desire to make a fair shoe in the flesh, they constrain you to be circumcised, only lest they should suffer persecution for the cross of Christ.
Okay, as many desire to make a fair show in the flesh, knowing that we that are in Christ Jesus are not of the flesh, but are of the Spirit. So those that desire to make a fair show in the flesh constrain you to be circumcised, only lest they should suffer persecution for the cross of Christ. Who does that sound like that constrain men to be circumcised?
It sounds like them Pharisees, brother.
Right. The men that were of the law, that dedicated themselves under the law, that boasted of the law, and had no respect for the Spirit and the grace of Jesus Christ, which Christ came forth and taught. Okay? And the liberty that Christ came forth and taught. So it says, only lest they should suffer persecution for the cross of Christ. They constrain you to be circumcised, but they don't want to suffer the persecution. And because they don't want to suffer the persecution for the cross of Christ, that means that they don't want to go through the walk that you have to go through to be partakers of the body of Christ. In other words, they are of worldly things. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like it tells you about they live according to the flesh and they live of their belly. Mm. Let's go there real quick. Go to the book of bear with me 1 second.
All right.
Go to the book of Philippians, the 3rd chapter, the one that you wanted to go to, right?
Yeah, cool.
They're having us going there anyway.
Yeah.
The 18th verse.
All right, beautiful. So Philippians 3 and 18, right?
Yeah, read that right quick.
All right, bro. For many walk, of whom I have told you often, and now tell you even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ.
Go ahead.
Whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is in their shame, who mind earthly things.
Right. These men are these type of men, the Lord tells you, that their God is their belly, and they mind earthly things. All right? They whose glory, okay, is in their shame.
Right.
And they mind earthly things, and their God is their belly, meaning they're about their welfare.
Right.
And that's the same mind that those Pharisees were in, and the same mind that these modern day Pharisees are in.
That's right.
Men that boast according to fleshly things like the law of Moses, which is done away with.
That's right.
So let's go back.
All right.
Galatians, the 6th chapter.
Galatians 6 and
read the 13th verse in there.
13th verse?
Yeah.
Galatians 6:13. For neither they themselves who are circumcised keep the law, but desire to have you circumcised, that they may glory in your flesh.
Right. Back to the same mind of the Pharisees of old,
right?
Okay, who was called the circumcision.
Mm-hmm.
The Jews were called the circumcision. And it says, they themselves who were circumcised did not keep the law. And it says, but they desire to have you circumcised that they may glory in your flesh. Ain't nothing under the sun. The same mind and the same philosophy is going on to today.
That's right.
With these people that are boasting of the law of Moses. That's something right. That has perished and has vanished away.
Mm.
Go ahead.
But God forbid that I should glory, save in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world is crucified unto me, and I unto the world.
Right. So Paul says, I should not glory except in one thing, and that's the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. And those of us that claim to be true believers in Christ, we must carry our cross. We must bear our cross.
That's right.
And the cross is the suffering and the tribulation that you have to go through to walk according to the mind of Christ and according to this gospel. According to the liberty of Christ that he taught when he was on the earth. That's the cross. To show the difference between the cross, when you read the teachings of Jesus Christ, you see the difference between the teachings of Jesus Christ and the difference between the laws of Moses or the Mosaic law. For those that try to push that Christ kept the law, you know what I'm saying? Yes, Christ kept the law.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he was sinless.
Right.
Yes, he kept the law. But he didn't teach the law.
Mm-mm.
Okay? He taught a different doctrine than the law of Moses. That's why he had so much or caught so much flack from the Pharisees.
Right, right, right.
That's why they killed him.
Mm.
But when the law was fulfilled in Christ Jesus, he came forth with a new covenant.
That's right.
And he made changes in the law. And he changed a lot of the customs.
That's right.
Read on.
15. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creature.
So the Lord is saying that's not important to him, circumcision or uncircumcision.
Well, brother, in Colossians 2:11, it spoke about that. You know, the circumcision not done by hand.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? But through Christ, something like that, if we can get right. That, you know?
Okay, go ahead on over there.
Yeah, let's get that right quick, man. Yeah, Colossians 2. Okay. Colossians 2:11, okay, in whom also ye are circumcised with the circumcision made without hands, in putting off the body of sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
So that means circumcised in the heart.
Right, right, right.
In the mind.
Mm.
Not according to the flesh or the foreskins of your penis.
That's right.
Okay, so go ahead on back to Galatians.
All right, reading Galatians the third.
Read that 15 verse again, 6 and 15.
All right, Galatians 6:15. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creature.
That's what's important with the Lord, becoming a new creature. Whether you are circumcised or uncircumcised.
Mm.
And I want to bring forth a point, too,
mm-hmm.
for the people that think that the Gentiles are not part of the body of Jesus Christ.
Mm.
You error not knowing the scriptures.
Mm.
Hold what you got there.
Right.
And turn the page right to Galatians, the fourth chapter, right?
Galatians, the fourth chapter.
Yeah. And, let's see. Bear with me 1 second.
Come on, bro.
Not Galatians. Let's make a quick correction here.
Mm-hmm.
And let's turn to Romans, the fourth chapter.
Romans, the fourth chapter. Romans, the fourth chapter.
We want to read from Romans, the fourth chapter, the sixth verse on down,
mm-hmm.
And I tell you when to stop. I think around...